and very good morning to all the students of class 9. I am Dinesh Ranjan and today I am going to start the second chapter of your main literature textbook, Beehive. The Sound of Music. Now this chapter, The Sound of Music, has two parts. In part 1, the author describes Evelyn Glennie, while in the second part, the same author describes the Shehnai of Bismillah. So first of all, let me talk about the author a little. The author is Deborah Cow, an India-born Canadian author and broadcaster. She is most famous for her numerous contributions to the Reader's Digest. Her famous articles for the magazine include profiles of Sweden's Queen Sylvia, actress Judi Dench, chimpanzee guru Jane Goodall, British composer Andrew Lloyd Webber, and IKEA founder Ingvar Kamprad. She has also authored bestsellers such as Carol, Practical Guide, and Lucille Teasdale, Doctor of Courage, and has been an on-air broadcaster for CBS Radio and CBS Television in London and Kerala. In the chapter, you will find a lot of detail, but I tell you the summary in short. This is a heart-touching story about the hard work and courage of a young woman, Evelyn Glennie, who was diagnosed with hearing disability at the age of 8. Her teachers discouraged her due to her disability, but she was keen to have a career in music. Percussionist Ron Forbes initiated her to the possibility of sensing music through means other than her ears. He trained her to sense music through different parts of the body. Practice and hard work slowly opened her body and mind to sounds and vibrations. She started listening to the music through different parts of her body, and she was so sensitive to the sounds, even the vibration. Through vibrations, she could catch the music. Evelyn eventually joined the famous Royal Academy of Music, worked very hard with a strong determination, and reached the top. In 1991, she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year Award. Apart from regular concerts, Evelyn gives free concerts in prisons and hospitals. She has accomplished more than most people twice her age and is an inspiration to all. I told you there are so many important things in this chapter. I will try to give you in short. First of all, how does Evelyn hear music? She hears music by sensing musical notes in different parts of her body. When Ron Forbes, the percussionist, tuned the drums to different notes, she realized that she could hear the higher and lower drums in different parts of her body. Eventually, she opened up her mind and body to the sounds and vibrations of music. After much hard work and determination, she could feel music flowing through every part of the body. While playing the xylophone, she could feel the vibrations traveling from the sticks to our fingertips and a resonance flowing from the drums into the room. On a wooden platform, she stands barefoot so that vibrations from the wooden floor can pass through her feet. Due to her courage and perseverance, she has become one of the most sought after percussionists all over the world. Well, she has been called a workaholic. Well, this term workaholic has been taken from alcoholic, one who cannot live without alcohol. In the same way, this word has been coined, workaholic, a person who is addicted to work, like alcohol. Due to her hearing loss and the determination to prove her worth in the field of music, Evelyn says that she is a workaholic. Being deaf but having a dream of making music her life, Evelyn had to work much harder than the normal musicians. She learned to feel the music through her body rather than hear it. This meant extreme hard work, as this meant training to feel music in a totally new way. She was very fortunate to have the support of the expert percussionist like Ron Forbes, but her courage to be the best in the world meant that she had to overcome her shortcomings in hearing and make the way of feeling music her strength. When you go through the chapter, you will find many things which are very interesting to know. How a person like Evelyn Glenn, who is physically impaired, could learn music this way. This story has a great moral for all of us, all the readers. Evelyn's inspirational story is a shining example of achievement and determination in spite of having hardships in life. This story tells us that if we have the willpower and determination to achieve our dreams, then nobody or nothing can stop us. The key message being communicated here through our story is that hard work is most important in life. And if one is able to sincerely do the hard work and keep the focus on the final goal, then one can achieve anything in life. Evelyn, despite her hearing disability, is one of the most sought after percussionists in the world. She has achieved more than most people twice her age and has become the symbol of hope for millions around her. As I told you, when you go through the story, you will also receive a lot of inspiration from this story. Now coming to the second part of this chapter, that also is related to the sound of music, the Shehnai of Ustad Bismillah Khan. You must have heard the name Ustad Bismillah Khan, household name in India. The same author is the same. Let us come to the summary. This lesson is about Shehnai maestro Ustad Bismillah Khan, born in 1916 and who died in 2006, whose skill took him all around the world, but he felt at peace only in his country. The lesson also makes us aware of the origins of Shehnai, the musical instrument with which Ustad Bismillah Khan's name is synonymous. Bismillah Khan, whose grandfather was a Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King's court, took to music early in life when he was only 3 years old. His life is a story of simplicity and communal harmony from the beginning, when he used to sing Chaita at Bihariji temple in Bihar. He would practice playing the Shehnai in the temples of Varanasi. Bismillah Khan got a break when All India Radio opened in Lucknow in 1930. Later, he got the honor of playing the Shehnai on 15th August 1947 when India was declared independent. The whole night he had played the Shehnai. Bismillah Khan gave many memorable performances in India and abroad and was honored with many awards. In 2001, Ustad Bismillah Khan was awarded India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. Now, some of the important points of this chapter. The first one is origin of Shehnai. How this musical instrument came into being. Shehnai originated in the time of Emperor Aurangzeb, who did not like the shrill sound of the musical instrument a phungi. Earlier it was known as phungi. He ordered a ban on playing the phungi in the palace. A barber in the royal palace improved the tonal quality of phungi by taking a longer and broader pipe with a natural hollow stem and making 7 holes in it. When he played on it, rhythmically opening and closing the holes, a soft and melodious sound was generated. When he played this new instrument in the palace, everyone was impressed. This marked the beginning of the modern day Shehnai, named after Shah the Emperor and Nai the Barber. The instrument is considered auspicious and played at weddings and temples. One question that arises, why did Aurangzeb put ban on phungi? Aurangzeb banned the playing of a phungi because of its shrill, unpleasant sound. Following this decision, phungi became a common name for reed noise makers. What is the difference between phungi and Shehnai? Shehnai is an improvement upon the phungi and has better tonal quality. It is made from a naturally hollow stem pipe in which 7 holes are drilled. It is longer and broader than a phungi. Now, where was the Shehnai traditionally played? The Shehnai was traditionally played in temples, courts and weddings. Ustad Bismillah Khan brought this instrument to the classical stage so that even the common people could enjoy it. Bismillah Khan, in the summary also I mentioned, he got his big break. Ustad Bismillah Khan got his big break in 1938 when All India Radio opened in Lucknow. He started playing Shehnai on the radio and became quite famous in a short span of time. Soon after, he became the first Indian to greet the nation with his Shehnai from the Red Fort on 15th August 1947. Now, we all know this 15th August 1947 was a historic day. On this very day, on 15th August 1947, Bismillah Khan played Raag Khafi on his Shehnai from the Red Fort. It was a historic event because it was the occasion of India's independence from the British rule. Well, an American offered him to start a school in United States, but Bismillah Khan flatly refused to start this school in US because he could not bear the thought of living away from his home, especially from Banaras, River Ganges and Dumra. Bismillah Khan loved India very much. In this story, there are two instances demonstrating how much he loved India. The first is He refused to start a Sinai school in the USA because River Ganga could not be replicated. The second instance is, when asked about moving to Pakistan at the time of partition, he said he would never leave Banaras. Some very memorable performances given by Ustad Bismillah Khan, which have been noted down in the chapter, are: he was credited with giving many memorable performances in India and abroad. Soon after, All India Radio started in Lucknow in 1938. Young Bismillah joined it and quickly became an often heard Sehnai player on radio. He was the first Sehnai player to greet Indians when the country gained independence on 15th August 1947. He played Raag Khafi from the Red Fort to the stately audience that included the first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He gave many other memorable performances, like the one to King Jahir Shah, King of Afghanistan. King Shah was so impressed with his talent that he gifted the Ustad priceless Persian carpets and a sovereign. So this way, we all can see Bismillah Khan was very famous, not only in India, but all over the world. And he will always remain in the memory of Indians. He was Bharat Ratna also, the greatest civilian award he had won for himself. So this way, the two parts are over. I hope when you go through these stories, the two parts, you will find everything that I have discussed. Thank you. Thank you very much.